Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to install the latest version of Eclipse IDE, that is Eclipse IDE version 2024-03 on a Windows operating system. And after that, I am also going to show you how you can easily run a simple Hello World Java program within our Eclipse IDE. So do watch the video till the end. If you face any issues in middle, you can always comment in your comment sections. I'll try my best to help you. Now to install Eclipse IDE, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser and to just simply search over here Eclipse IDE and hit enter. And immediately you'll be able to see this eclipseide.org as a first search result. So you have to click on this Eclipse IDE. And when you click on that, it's going to redirect to the official site of eclipseide.org. So here you can see that our latest version of Eclipse IDE, that is version 2024-03, is available to download. So you click on this button and it's going to redirect to this, you know, instructions page. So you can always read this documentation. So this documentation also clearly shows you all the steps on how to install Eclipse IDE. Don't worry, I'm going to show you all the steps on this video itself. So what you need to do is you need to click on, see the step one, we need to click on this link. So in step one, we have this link. So when you click on this link, you'll get this eclipse.org/downloads page. So this link I'm going to provide right in our description. So you can directly use that link to land over to the official site of Eclipse Foundation. And once when you are here, you'll be able to see this download button. So you click on this download button. Again, it's going to redirect to this page. Again, you will see a download button. Click on this download button and there you go. Thank you for your download. Our Eclipse is rightly started downloading over here. You can see it is rightly started downloading over here, right? So since I have already downloaded it, so I'll cancel this. I'll minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory and here you can see that our Eclipse IDE is already been downloaded over here. So to install it, just simply double click on the installer. And here you need to just simply click on install anyway. So you can see that our Eclipse installer is rightly opened over here. So let's first minimize our download directory. And you can see that our Eclipse installer is rightly opened over here. And you can see all the different programming languages like Java, C++, or PHP, and all these different languages you can use in our Eclipse IDE, right? So in this video, I'm going to talk about how you can use our Eclipse IDE for Java. In my previous videos, I have already discussed how we can use our Eclipse IDE for C and C++ programming. So now you can also watch that video as well if you're interested to use Eclipse IDE for C or C++. Right. So in this video, I'm going to talk about how you can use the Eclipse IDE for Java developers. So you have to click on the first one and it's going to redirect to this page. Now here you can see that it has properly recognized our latest version of Java, that is Java JDK version 22. So in my previous videos, I have showed you how to install Java so that Java latest version of Java version 22 path is properly recognized over here, right? So if you see that you don't have Java installed, so if you don't see this path, you can always download all these different Java version, that is 22, 21 or 17, from all these links. So you need to select one of the link and then you need to proceed with install. Alright, since I have already Java installed, so I'm going to select the default path where we have installed Java previously. So you need to select that first one and here it's going to install our Eclipse. Alright, so you can see it's going to create first Eclipse folder and then within Eclipse folder it's going to create the latest versions folder, that is 2024-03, and here it's going to install all the files. So everything is fine, just simply click on install and it's going to start installing our Eclipse. Before that, it asks you for administrative privileges. You can always read this and then accept the license agreement and immediately you'll be able to see that our installation is rightly begun. So let's wait for a couple of minutes to get it finished installing our Eclipse. One thing to be noted is you need to have active internet connection right throughout this installation, as it's going to fetch some of the files from internet and going to install it locally on your system. So you need to have active internet connection and it will take, you know, about a couple of minutes. So after that, I'm going to again come back to this video. Yep. So we'll come back and now you can clearly see that our Eclipse IDE is rightly installed. Also you can see desktop shortcut is also created over here. So everything is good. We have a launch button here as well. So you need to click on the launch button to launch our Eclipse IDE. You can also double click on the shortcut to launch our Eclipse IDE. So you can see Eclipse IDE slightly started launching, and here it is telling to select a workspace. I'm going to keep it default, so it's going to use Eclipse-workspace folder. So inside this folder, it's going to create all the projects, whatever we are going to create within Eclipse IDE. So everything is fine, just simply click on launch. And you can see our Eclipse IDE version 2024-03 is rightly started launching. And you can see that it is rightly launched. So you can always maximize this. So when you maximize, you'll be able to see this welcome note. So welcome to Eclipse IDE for Java developers. You can always, you know, read all the information. You can also donate some amount to help them, because they have really developed a very good software. So if it shows this type of message, you can always, you know, read this. You can select any of the option. For now, I'm going to just simply click on cancel. So you're going to keep everything as default. So you can always read all the information from here, but I'm going to show you all the things in this video itself, so you can just follow along this video. First thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to cancel this welcome note, and then you'll be seeing this interface. So from here, you can always click on create a Java project to create a Java project window, or you can also go to file and hover over new and then click on Java project. So that will also going to open the same new Java project window. Alright, so here I need to give you a project name. So let's give the project name as Hello World. And you can see that we have GRE JDK 22. So I'm going to use that, use default GRE JDK 22, because that is what we have installed. You can also select user project specific to GRE JDK 22, whichever you like. Okay, for now I'm going to select this one, and I don't want to create any module-info.java file, because it's just a simple Hello World Java project, so you don't want to create any module for that. All right, so all other things are fine. Just simply click on finish, and you can see that our Hello World project is actually created over here. You can always expand this. You'll be able to see GRE system library, that is latest version of JDK 22 it is using, and we have a src folder. So you need to just right click and create a new class file over here. So here you need to give your class name, which will be Hello World itself, and I'm going to also select this public static void main. All right, so it's going to automatically create a main method. So everything is fine. Click on finish. So it's going to start creating our Hello World.java class, and you can see our class is also rightly opened over here. So what you need to do is you need to just simply hit enter over here, and if you just simply type system.out.println, and within that, if you just simply give something like Hello World, so this is what we want it to print on our console. So if you write something like this, and we have a type over here, so this L is not required, so it will be println only. So you know, if you just simply write this much and click on the run button, it will show you to save and launch. So click on OK. So it's going to save our file, and it's going to start building our project, and after it gets successfully built, it's going to show you the output Hello World within our console. Alright, so in this way you can easily create new project. You can always go to file and hover over new, and you can create again a new Java project. So all projects are going to be listed under this package explorer menu. So now everything is fine. I hope you really enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please give it a like, and also don't forget to subscribe our channel. We have also started Geeky Syntax channel, so here regularly I'm posting coding related videos, so please do subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel. And also if you're interested, you can also subscribe our Geeky Script blogging channel. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.